Hi all, I'm Kezia. I'm going to talk to you about how to start your Canada plan and how not to. Also, we are going to see the reality of the fake promises and the scams. So please do watch till the end. Don't forget to share this video with those who have the plan for Canada immigration. We can save their hard-earned money. Hi all, hope all you are safe in your places. So here I'm Kezia again in Newfoundland area with another episode of the Canadian Dreams or Plans. Considering the current situation, I just postponed my plans on the Canadian documents. I am getting huge response in terms of messages, mails, like asking for help, clarity or guidance regarding the immigration plans. So I thought of doing this video on how to start your Canada plans or how not to do this. See, once you came across a thought of moving to Canada, please don't jump immediately to an agency and pay your hard-earned money for a worthless steps like a zero step or unnecessary steps in the beginning. I know there are some genuine agencies doing serving their clients in a better way, but there are a lot of agencies who do not. My intention with this video is not to discourage or not blame any particular agencies. Instead, I just want you to know the reality. Even if you are going through an agency, there are like 80% or more than that you should do by yourself, like your IELTS, your ECA, and getting all your required documents in a specified formats and all. Then paying your huge money in terms of lakhs to these agencies and then waiting for the agencies to pick your call or respond to your mails. I know this is a hard situation. Actually, it's a frustrating situation. There is nothing you can do but waiting once you let your hard-earned money out of your hands. So my suggestion or my point here is to do some effort by your end before you pay someone, before you just jump on to agencies, especially for the pilot programs like APP and RNIP, which basically requires a job offer to start your process. Agencies can't really help you with this, like to get a Canadian job from these Atlantic provinces and RNIP participating communities in Canada. It's not agency's fault, but it's you who know you better, your job culture, your past jobs, the technologies and the tools you used. In short, everything about your job culture. I have told by my friends, viewers, that they have paid a lot of money to agencies, claiming that the agencies will get them a job offer from these Atlantic provinces for APP program and these participating communities for RNIP programs. But they haven't get any positive response from these agencies. And for those who heard back from the agencies, it was again more money matters. I want you to understand that there is no money matters in getting a job offer. Like we don't have to pay any single penny to get a job offer from these Canadian employers. What really matters is your talent, your skills, your duties and responsibilities that matches the employer's openings, vacancies. You know what really matters while you applying for a job? For each job, even from the same NOC or similar NOC, and even from the same field or within the company, may have different job requirements. At least they do differ in the keywords that describing your duties and responsibilities that you should perform while in that job. So you would need to customize your resume based on this, that is to best match this recruitment or the position you are applying. It doesn't mean that you need to fake your profile or you need to make up an experience that you don't have. Coming to the resume, this resume should be in Canadian format. Please do some research and follow the steps that I shared in my previous videos. And if possible, get more some insight. And just do not blindly copy paste someone else's profile or someone else's resume. Take some good effort, your customization skill and a time considering the each position you are applying. So it's not a single resume for every job. Customization is very much important. Again, and next point is, do not apply for every job. I used to get messages saying that they are fed up of applying the hundreds of jobs in a week and not getting any response. It is always advisable to apply for a job or a vacancy if you feel like the 80% of the requirements are best matching to your profile, that you have almost things that mentioned in requirement. You can still apply if you feel like, yes, half of the requirement are matching to my profile, but the chances of getting an interview is much higher in the first criteria. I hope you got what I mean. I don't want you to feel disappointed thinking that I applied 10 to 15 jobs in this week, but I haven't heard back yet. And in this situation, like the COVID situation, as far as I know, the Canadian employees are preferring the candidates within Canada. They may be hiring, but the procedures are very much slowed down. So I don't think this is the best time to apply for jobs, but you can prepare very well in this time. So coming to the question, is it really possible to get a job offer from agencies, especially for the programs like APP, RNAP and PNP programs? I would say no, because I haven't came across any people who got job through agencies, but I have came across people who have succeeded finding a job themselves. Even I am in that category because I did it for myself. Basically, the fact is really simple, because no one in the agencies know that what you are, what you are doing in your profession. So they can't basically customize your profile for every job or every opening they're applying. If a resume didn't pass to the process, you will not be getting any interview calls. So no job. So I hope you got it. Next big factor is the fake job offers. I have came across few fake job offers in which a few of them are given by the agencies to their clients. There are different ways of understanding a job offer, whether it's a fake or not. But basically, the simple fact is, if anybody is asking you a money, particular amount of money, of course it's fake. I've seen a job offer letter in which they have mentioned that the candidate need to pay a particular amount of money in Indian rupee, which is equivalent to some particular Canadian amount, for their verification or some sort of things. This is a fake job offer. And there were some other job offers which was not claiming money in the job offer, but it was showing a huge amount of salary, more than realistic. These job offer letters are coming in the name of the genuine companies that are already existing in Canada. So for few of them, I have contacted these employers directly and have reported these job offers to the real employers. Trust me, no Canadian employer will ask you for money. Their part is to get you a job offer. And even if they are assisting you with the next steps, like to until you get a work permit or the permanent residency, they will not ask you money at any stages. You may have to do your verification things, your medical stuffs, your biometrics things, but all you have to go through is some designated medical officers and VFS officers listed on government website. You have to pay there, not to any agencies, and there is no shortcut for it. And these amounts are very reasonable. It's not that huge. If you are confused with a job offer, you can't determine whether it's a fake or good one, you can proceed until and unless they haven't asked you any money. If they demand you money, just quit and escape. Don't waste your money. Scams are happening because we are trying to go through some shortcuts. You can't get a Canadian job offer from your country if you don't have an experience in that particular job for at least 1 year. I know my friend who been fooled by an agency in India because she believed that she would get a Canadian job directly without having an Indian experience. Canada reference or reference matters, but it cannot do anything if you don't have any relevant experience. So next thing is, if you're looking to learn information regarding the Canada plans, do stick to the official website. It have abundant of information. You can also refer to the YouTube channels. You can get the advices from the people who are experienced in this. from their personal experiences. Actually, I came to know about this APP program through a YouTube channel, but as he was not in Canada and as he was not an experienced person, I went to the official pages to dig more about this program and to get my current employer. And in the official page, there are some links if you are going through the express entry to check your CRS score. You can play around it to know what are the things possibly you can improve to get a good score. And don't go through the random pages asking you to check your eligibility for a Canada job or PR. If you drop your mail address or contact details in that, the agencies will call you regarding the next things, the money things. Please understand that the Canada PR or the job offers are not readily available for anyone. We need to do some effort. We need to spend some time, and it's our own effort that matters. So don't get fooled or trapped by false promises, false agencies. Do some research. Get some information through the official website. Refer YouTube for factual and experienced suggestions. Get advices. Speak with the experienced people. Do your effort. Think with your logic and make a decision. It's your call. It's not a sin to go to agencies if you have a job offer or all your documents handy. There are a lot of people who went to Canada PR through agencies because these agencies were doing great on the paperwork. And still, you can go to agencies if you don't have time, if you are not confident to do your paperwork on, and if you really don't want to take chance on the paperwork, you can definitely go through agencies. But before you go, ensure that you have your job, you have all the necessary documents like IELTS, all these things. Agencies are a bit pricey, but they'll help you with the paperwork in a very really fast manner. I hope I could share some insight on this topic, and I hope it really helps you. Thank you for watching my video. Thanks for all your support. If you like this video, please do hit the thumb icon. Share it to those people who really needs it. Stay tuned by subscribing to my channel. See you.